Does it blend? Yes, it does. Do we know what's in it? No, we don't.
The theme of today. What an informative show we're making here.
Our top story tonight, Wine for the People, is a Venice-based YouTube channel where we blind review wines, kindly supplied to us by the friends at Different Drop. We've got three wines in front of us. We don't know what the price is, what's inside them, where it's going to tell you how good they are, what we think of them, and we're going to try and guess the blend. If you haven't already, please like and subscribe to the channel. It's massively important, but let's not muck around too much. Let's get into the video.
All right, three wines. Will it blend? Did you ever used to watch that on YouTube? Will it blend with our selling the blenders? I wonder if that's how they blended these. We'll see.
I reckon it's seen a little bit of oak potentially. No, it's definitely seen some oak, not potentially, definitely.
Oh yeah, alrighty, I'm going Etna. Etna Bianco, because it's lovely, salty, textural, it's got everything going for it. Very food-focused wine.
Honestly, if you didn't tell me that it was blended, I would have just straight up guessed straight Chenin Blanc, so I don't really know what it is.
Cool. Bit of Pinot Gris and a bit of Vermentino.
Lovely, salty, lean, textural, it's got everything going for it. Very food-focused wine. This, some sardines, and some sunshine, season two of the White Lotus. This is what we got right here.
A great amount of batonnage. Like, this is real all class, done with a really nice, fun, contemporary edge. Gonna roll with around about $40 a bottle, and I wanna buy six. I would guess Chenin Semillon.
Here's the red blends. This one looks quite vibrant, doesn't look like it's particularly, I don't know why I'm rubbing my eye like a child who's having a tantrum. It looks quite vibrant.
Yeah, it's got that lovely bright cherry thing. There's a nice spice there. Some richer, darker fruits, which automatically, I'm gonna go Aussie GSM.
Yummy. A bit like, here's a funny thing. The back palate of this is quite savory, salty and briny and quite clipped. Whereas the front palate is, it's all luscious and juicy fruit.
Yeah, nice. Very short palate length. As soon as you swallowed it, it's not in your mouth anymore, which I know sounds really dumb, but like some wines tend to stick around. This absolutely pisses off.
I think this is really good. Definitely leaning on the spicy front, which I don't mind. Could be, I'm gonna go McVale, and I'm gonna go $28, which is what I think 20 GSM should be. So adjusting for inflation, I'll take that up to 32.
I think it's probably Syrah something or other. Let's call it Syrah Sangiovese.
And finally, one number three. Looks like the darkest of the three blends.
Really kind of like olive tapenade and savory.
I think that's actually pretty good. Of the three, for me, this is the strongest wine. It's full, complete, rich, round, front palate, mid palate, no hole in the middle.
Unreal. Really smooth. I reckon it's got some Shiraz in there. Quite savory and a little bit of heat almost coming through, but on the front, it's got this really pretty big red fruits, stone fruits, cherries, that sort of thing, and then the lovely savory finish.
A bit more structural tannin, a bit of meaty chew to it as well. Bugger. It's Mataro dominant. It's definitely not Mataro submissive. And I'm gonna go $38, magic number.
And I am going to spend $50 a bottle on it, and I'm gonna buy 12 because I just know that it's gonna mature gracefully in the cellar and it's gonna reward me in not every occasion. You know, if I have 12 bottles of this and I, you know, encounter it and have the desire for one of these once every 3 months, then it's gonna last me a number of years. I actually kind of think this is a Shiraz Cab blend.
It's exactly what I'm looking for in a like medium leading heavy red blend. Quite bright and fun on the front of the palate. So into that as well, have another Daz, and we'll call that $40 a bottle. Interesting to see what the boys think.
Wines, three blind wines.
Three blind wines.
Yeah. Blends.
Yes.
The guys at Different Drop gave us blends to pick. Mean.
Dicks.
with that being said, the wines were actually quite delicious.
Oh, they were tasty as hell.
Yeah, 100%.
I was into all three, some more than others, but good wines.
This is the thing about blends. Love blends. Hate drinking them on this show, though, because it is impossible to pick things. Like, for me, like, there's no...
I like them. I'll be the yin to your yang.
Because I like it.
I am like... You've heard my monologue about the uselessness of just blind identifying a wine is just a massive ego play. Like,
yes.
This forces you to kind of go, fuck the variety, Is it good quality wine? Is it good, the thing that actually matters, is it tasty, good quality wine? You know, and I love the idea that it kind of like takes that whole conversation IDing out of it. Nevertheless, I did try to ID a whole bunch.
Of course you did.
Yeah. First wine, yummy. Savory, saline, briny, delicious little white wine that had me saying Etna Bianco.
Cool. Completely agree on your savory, salty little thing. Quite often with wines like that, I'll hate them. Didn't hate this. This is quite a nice example of it.
I thought it was a Chenin something or other. I just randomly chose another variety. I just said Semillon.
Yeah, I called Chardonnay Pinot Grigio Vermentino blend.
Prawn toast. Buttered prawn
toast. Yep.
Chardonnay Pinot Grigio Vermentino. I love it.
Be a lot cooler if you did.
It is...
product of Portugal. Fuck. Douro Bianco. Yeah,
I don't know what Douro Bianco is. I know recently I've been trying a lot of Encruzado. Perhaps, I mean, that kind of gives me similar sort of vibes as sort of Chenin-y Chardonnay.
Okay. Xisto Limitado, Ilimitado. Is this like X is the limit, so the limit does not exist? I don't know.
Or there is a limit to your existence.
We're getting way
real
too
existential
deep.
Wine. I love that. Honestly, delicious. Great, again, food wine, 100% food wine. Yeah, any kind of briny fish and chips or stuff like
which
that.
Which makes sense if you live in Portugal as well.
Yeah,
totally.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Portuguese famously do eat food.
Does it blend? Yes, it does.
Yes,
do we
it does.
Know what's in the blend? No, we don't, but you know.
Number two, I mean, it looked pretty just like a typical red blend.
Num, num, num.
It was delicious.
Num, num, num.
It was really tasty. So like immediately I'm like, it's Australian GSM because it just looks like red blend.
Oops.
I was sort of here or there about it. I wanted three. I wanted to spend $23.
Oh, no, you're wrong. I wanted a dozen and I wanted to spend 35.
I wanted three at 32.
It turns out I was wrong. How much was it? Hey! There it is.
Right, Henry.
And I was right as well. I did want a dozen
of
it.
We've got another, it's a Frenchie.
Aria's Pinot Gamay.
This is all written in French. Nous l'avons jamais le verre vide son nefis de souvenir. Does that mean anything to you? I got no idea what's in that.
Brett, you do the best French.
Wow, dude, right here. I'm right here.
It would be some kind of like, Pinot Gamay blend.
Cab Franc.
I imagine.
Grollo, is it Loire?
Grollo.
It's product of France. Yeah. So we don't know where it's from or what's in it.
Does it blend? Yes, it does. Do we know what's in it? No, we don't.
The theme of today. What an informative show we're making here.
This, though, was my favorite.
Yeah,
favorite?
I agree.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was spicy, savory. Like, it felt like Mataro dominant or something like that.
I went Shiraz cab.
I went...
Classic Aussie.
I got overtaken by the Shiraz in there and forgot that we were doing blends, so just guessed it was a Shiraz.
I went
Mataro Dom. Lockie, what is it?
Giant Steps.
Shiraz, Carignan, and Grenache.
Hey, dude, Shiraz Mataro is as close as I reckon Grenache cross Carignan's pretty much like Mataro.
Yeah, exactly.
You've always said that. You have always said that.
It's kind of good. Like, sometimes it's confected and sometimes it's really savory.
Gravity Flow. Oh, it's a Gravity Flow winery. That's cool.
Yeah, these guys are real nerdy. And they got the money to do it.
Depths are like the Yangara of Victoria.
Yeah, with their own by the same people.
Sweet. Can you compare that to Wolf Blast to put it in terms I understand?
They're not Wolf Blast.
Thank you. Just
that's all we need to say.
I also did the really pretentious swish it round, look at the legs, and then try and guess the alcohol percentage. Nailed it on that one.
13.5?
Yeah.
Well done.
Thank you.
Good on you, King.
Yeah.
None of it says any meaning anymore.
Are we going this one alone?
Yeah, 100%.
100%. That was so good. So impressive.
Yeah, good stuff. Local, $35. That's good value. But yeah, that's one of the week. Get some of that just as the weather starts cooling down. It continues to cool down.
Yeah.
And we'll see you next week.
Bye.
Ciao. Let's just do it.